again. So today we will discuss Cauchy integral theorem. So let's first write down the formulation of this theorem, the statement, and then we will prove this statement. Okay, so what do we have in this theorem? So let f of z be analytic everywhere within. Let f of z be analytic everywhere within and on a simple closed positively oriented control. Everywhere is in and on a simple closed positively oriented contour, let's call it contour. Let's give it a name. And then if z sub 0 is a point, is any point interior to C, and if z sub 0 is any point interior to C, then the following formula holds. Then the formula can be written in I will write it in two ways. F at z sub zero equals to integral along C f of z dz over z minus z sub zero, and I forgot the factor, so here we have 1 over 2 pi I. Right, so f of z sub 0 equals 1 over 2 pi I integral on C f of z dz over z minus z sub 0. Or I will rewrite this formula in following way. I will multiply by 2 pi I everything. So I will rewrite this formula in the following way. I will write integral along contour C f of z dz over z minus z sub 0 equals to 2 pi I f at z sub 0. So this is the formula we would like to prove. So let me draw. Let's read again. So we have function f of z, and this function is analytic where. So we have this contour C, right? So contour C. We know that this is simple, so no self-intersections. We know that this is closed, so it is a loop, positively oriented. It means if our interior here, right? So we go around and every time our enclosed domain is on the left. So it's positively oriented contour, and the point z sub 0 is somewhere inside. So we have point z sub 0 somewhere inside. So let's recall. So what happens if z sub 0 is outside? Let's look in the integrand here. So we know that f of z is analytic. But in the integral, we not only have f of z, we have f of z divided by z minus z sub 0. So now we're considering function, let's called g of z, and this is a function f of z, z minus z sub zero. So this is our function, and the only point where this function g is not analytic, it's point z sub zero. So if point z sub zero is outside, then the entire function g of z is analytic inside. And according to Cauchy-Gourcy theorem that we discussed in the previous lecture, we will have that the whole integral would be zero, right? So if z sub zero is outside, then the integral is zero. So what happens if z sub zero is inside? We also, when we were talking about Cauchy-Gourcy theorem, we mentioned that if we have a non-simply connected domain, right? So now if we think about function g of z and we think about domain enclosed by our contour C, we can think of this as a domain without this point. So and we were talking in the last lecture, we mentioned that if we have two contours that even if domain is not simply connected, if two contours could be deformed one to the other in a continuous matter, right? If they homotopic to each other, right? So continuously may be deformed from one to another, then the integral will not change. So instead of contour C, we can consider this contour, right? Or we can go even further and look at a small circle, right? It doesn't, C doesn't have to be a circular contour. It's not important, but for computational purposes, we will take small circle and we call this circle CR. So now, instead of integral along contour C, we will look at the following integral. So we will, instead of this one, it will be equal to along CR, where CR is small circle, centered at z sub zero. Here we will have f of z dz over z minus z sub zero. And then we will do the following trick. We know that f, function f itself, not g, f is analytic at point z sub zero. So the value f evaluated at z sub zero makes sense. And we can add and subtract. So what we will do, we'll write integral along contour CR, and then we will have f at z minus f at z sub zero plus f at z sub zero divided by z minus z sub zero dz. So now this is our new integral. It's obviously equals to the first one. And then what we will do, we will split this integral into two. So we will split this integral into first integral along CR, f of z minus f at z sub zero, over z minus z sub zero dz, plus integral along CR f at z sub zero dz z minus z sub zero. So we have these two integrals. And first, let's look at the second integral and let's compute it. We know that we have somewhere here point z sub zero, and we have a small circle with radius r. This is radius of our circle. It doesn't look like a circle, but it is a circle. Right, so this is a circle, and so z sub zero is the center of this circle, and the point z, it runs here. So point z, all point z, they live on the circle. So now let's compute this integral. How we can compute it? We can use parameterization. So let's use parameterization. What would be our parameterization? Let's introduce parameter say theta, and we can call z equals z sub 0 plus r e to the I theta. And what is dz? Dz would be equals to, when we differentiate, it would be r I e I theta d theta. And theta runs from 0 to 2 pi. And what we will have, our integral along CR of f at z sub 0 dz, z minus z sub 0 would be equal to. So what we can do, f at z sub 0 can be just pulled out. It's just a number, f evaluated at point z sub 0. So we will pull it out, f at z sub 0, and then introducing our parameterization, integral would be from 0 to 2 pi, right? Integral from 0 to 2 pi, and z minus z sub 0 in the bottom will become, so we have, this is z, z sub 0 plus r e to the I theta minus z sub 0. So z sub 0 would be cancelled, and we will just have the r e to the I theta, and on top we have just dz. Dz is r I e to the I theta d theta. And then we can cancel out r e to the I theta on top and the bottom. So integral will have just I. It will be I d theta. I can be pulled out. So we will have just integral, we'll have f at z sub 0 times I times integral from 0 to 2 pi d theta. And obviously this integral antiderivative would be theta, and we will have just 2 pi. So the integral is 2 pi I f at z sub 0. We computed this integral, so now let's compare our result with what we were trying to prove. So here is our formula that we are trying to prove. Right? So this is our formula. And we see that we already received what we wanted to from the entire integral. We wanted the value 2 pi I f at z sub 0, and we already got it. What does it tell us? It tells us that the first integral must be 0. So let's show that the first integral is 0. I will probably erase theorem, right? So let's recall it again, that let's f be analytic everywhere within and on a simple closed positive oriented contour. If z sub 0 is any point interior to C, then we have this formula, or equivalently this formula. Right, so we are proving this theorem. Just second part, what I want to prove. What I want to prove is that the first integral, so show that this integral along CR f of z minus f at z sub 0, z minus z sub 0 dz equals 0. This is my goal. So let's look at our integral. What do we know about function f of z? We know that function f of z is analytic. And analytic means differentiable. It obviously means that this function is continuous. So we have a continuous function. And now let's see what happens if, let's look at this picture, right? So here we have z sub 0 and we have point z. So what will be happening if r will be going to 0? Maybe just I can specify what I want to show, that this goes to 0 as r goes to 0. Because eventually it then will be equal to 0. So what happens? If r goes to 0, radius becomes smaller and smaller, right? Then distance between two points, z sub 0 and z, will be also smaller and smaller. So we will have distance between z minus z sub 0, this distance will be decreasing, right? Will be getting smaller. We can say goes to 0 as r goes to 0. And our function is continuous. So then what can we say about this f of z minus f at z sub 0? About the difference of values, right? Modulus of this difference. So we know that if function is continuous, then if we take points close and close to each other, then values will be also close and close to each other. So then we can say that it will be something bounded if our radius is small enough. So let's call this bound mr. So m is a constant, right? So this difference can be evaluated as m, and the smaller is r, the smaller is this difference. So m depends on r, and mr goes to 0 as r goes to 0, right? Also mr would be decreasing, goes to 0 as r goes to 0. And now let's just evaluate this integral. Let's take modulus of this integral along CR f of z minus f at z sub 0 over z minus z sub 0 dz. And let's even say that this is, let's choose m in such that it's not equal, that it's less or equal, right? So we can write that it will be less or equal then. So let's say that this would be, for instance, a maximum. So maybe it's better to say that let's call mr, I will correct slightly, let's call mr, say maximum. So maximum for chosen r, and then for all other r's smaller than that, we will have that this f of z minus f of zero can be smaller than mr is a constant, can be pulled out. And here we have integral cr dz z minus z sub 0. And what can we say about this integral? We just computed this integral here, and we know that value of this integral is just 2 pi I. So the value of this integral is just 2 pi I. And what is the modulus of 2 pi I? Modulus of 2 pi I is 2 pi. So we will have, it's equals to 2 pi m r. And since we know that when r goes to 0, m r also goes to 0, so then we can write that limit m r as r goes to 0 is 0, and this finishes the proof. Okay, so now let's consider some examples for Cauchy integral formula. Example number one. Let's compare two integrals. Not in the sense of comparing, but in the sense let's look at the difference. So we will take two different contours, but the same function. So we will have, say, e to the z squared over z minus 2 dz. And the second integral would be this z equals 3 e to the z squared dz over z minus 2. Z minus 2. So let's look at these two integrals. So what would be our approach to comparing the integrals? Remember, we said that when we talk about Cauchy integral formula, it's important whether or not point z sub 0 is inside or outside of the contour. So let's look at this function. We see that e to the square is analytic everywhere in the disk, so we have our unit disk centered at the origin, radius 1, and our point z sub 0 is 2, so point is somewhere here. And we can see that the point is outside of the circle. Here, in this case, we have a bigger circle with radius 3, point 2 is inside. What does it tell us? That value of the first integral is 0, and the value of the second integral is not 0, because we have point 2 inside of the circle. So we know that it should be 2 pi I times f at z sub 0. Our z sub 0 now is 2, our f is e to the z squared, so it will be e to the z squared evaluated at the point z equals 2. So we will have 2 pi I e to the fourth. Okay, so if you have questions, just please email them to me. Let's do another example. So example 2. Example 2. Let C be a contour. Let C be a contour. Z minus 2 equals 3. So we have a circle centered at point 2 of radius 3 traced in a positive direction. And we need to compute several integrals. So let's compute several integrals. First of them would be, say, A, integral on this circle, C, let's call it C. And the function is e to the z plus sine z over z dz. And again, we will use the same approach as we used before, right? So what we need to do? We need to look at the integrand, right? At this function, and we need to draw the contour. So contour is a circle. A circle that centers at point 2 and radius 3. Right, so this point would be, say, negative 1, and this would be 2 plus 3, 5. Right, so this is our circle. And what is our point z sub 0? Our point z sub 0 now is z minus 0. Right, so our point z sub 0 is 0. So let me put center, I will use dots, and I will use this cross as our singular point. So what would be the value of this integral? The value of this integral would be, we have to write again 2 pi I, and f, our function, evaluated at point 0. So we will have our function e to the z plus sine z, and all these evaluated at point z equals 0. So we will get e to the 0 is 1, sine 0 is 0, so we will have just 2 pi I. 2 pi I. Okay, so now let's still keep the same contour, but look at a different function. For the second example would be b, if we have b would be, we have integral along the same contour. So here function cos z, z squared minus 4 dz. Let's rewrite the bottom, let's factor it. So we will have integral c cosine z dz, z minus 2, z plus 2. So we have two points where the denominator vanishes, point 2 and negative 2. Where those points are compared to our contour, and contour is traced in a positive direction. So point 2 is inside, right? And point z equals, why do I have here negative 3? It should be negative 1, right? So it should be negative 1 because center at the 2, radius 3, 2 minus 3 is negative 1. So again, so point z equals 2 is inside, point z equals negative 2 would be outside. It means that we just need to take into account only one point, z equals 2. So now this point is good. Then let's rewrite our integral in this way. So z minus z sub 0 will be z minus 2. And our function f is cosine z over z plus 2 dz. This is our contour. So the integral would be equal to 2 pi I, and then f, this is our f, evaluated at point 2. It will be cosine z, z plus 2, evaluated at point z equals 2. So we will have 2 pi I cosine of 2 over 4. And that would be 2 and 2 will be cancelled. Pi I cosine 2 over 2. This was our next integral. Let's do another example. And we still can keep the same contour. Let's do one more. So that would be perhaps C. And this time let's have the same contour. Here we'll have z squared e to the z. and 2z plus I dz. Let's look at this integral. So here in the bottom we don't have exactly an expression z minus z sub zero. So let's rewrite this integral in the desired form. We can do it here, right? So how rewrite this? If I pull out 1/2, see, and here I will write 1/2 z squared e to the z dz, and here it will be just z plus I over 2. And now we can clearly see that our z sub 0 is negative I over 2. So this is one of the common mistakes when people forget that the denominator is not written in the form z minus z sub 0. Okay, and then what we will get equals 2. It will be 2 pi I 1/2 z squared e to the z evaluated at the point z equals negative I over 2. And now we will have here pi I. Z squared will give us negative will be squared, I squared will give us a minus negative 1/4 and e to the negative I over 2, which basically is our answer, negative pi I over 4 e to the negative I over 2. And one comment probably it would be good to make here, that what if we have a contour trace not in the positive direction but in the negative direction, what would be different? The only difference would be just we will have to change the sign, so instead of minus then we will have a plus. So we're done with this example. Let's do another example. Now we will play, so here we're playing with different functions and the same contour. Now let's have one function and play with different contours. So the integral is here. Will be example, I don't know, maybe number 3, integral c dz z squared plus 9. This is our function, and let's look at three different situations regarding contour c. So first situation would be we will have let me rewrite the denominator as a product, so we'll have integral on c dz, and here it will be z minus 3i z plus 3i, z minus 3i z plus 3i. This is how we can factor z plus z squared plus 9. So first contour would be when 3i is a point of interior is a point of interior is, let's say, in point of interior to C, and negative 3i is outside of the contour. So second situation would be when negative 3i is inside, and 3i is outside And the third situation would be then both 3i and negative 3i are inside. So let's make a picture. So here is the picture. Here is our point 3i. Here is our point negative 3i. And in the first situation, we have a contour that surrounds point 3i and not negative 3i. So we can have a contour like that, and we assume that contour is traced in the positive direction. What would be the value of this integral? To compute the value of this integral, case one, we will write integral along our contour. Let's call this contour C1. So along contour C1, and then what this z minus d sub zero would be this expression. So our function is 1 over z plus 3 i's z minus 3 i. So this would be our function f. So then the integral would be equal to 2 pi I, and this function 1 over z plus 3 i's evaluated at the point z equals 3i. So we will have 2 pi I, 3i plus 3i, 6i. We will have 2 pi I over 6 i's. I and I would be cancelled, and we will have just pi over 3. Okay, that was case number one. So in the case number two, we will have a contour that has negative 3 inside. So that would be this contour, right? This would be contour C2. So in the second case, integral along contour C2 of the same function, and now our point z sub 0 would be point negative 3 i's, so we will have z, say, minus negative 3 i, which is the same as z plus 3 i. And here we will have 1 over z minus 3 i dz. And this integral would be equal to 2 pi I, our function f, 1 over z minus 3i, evaluated at the point z equals negative 3i's. And we will have 2 pi I divided by negative 3i and negative 3i, negative 6i, which will give us negative pi over 3. This was the second case. And in the third case, case number 3, our contour surrounds both points. So what we can do? We can think of this contour. So this is our point 3i. This is point negative 3i. So this is our contour C, traced in the positive direction. And we know that we can deform this contour continuously. So this would be also a valid contour, so the value of the integral will not change. And finally, not finally, but the next step, we can deform our contour into something like this, in positive direction. And here we can make these two sides really, really close to each other. So the integral will be basically computing along the same line back and forth, so they will cancel each other. And we will end up with two contours. One would be C1 and the second contour would be just contour C2. So in the third case, integral along contour C would be equals to integral along C1 of the same function plus integral along C2, and that would be pi over 3 minus pi over 3. That integral is 0. Okay, so here we saw how we can separate singularities. So instead of computing one integral with two singularities, we just split this integral into two, and each of the integrals has only one singularity. And let's do one more example. So here we need to show the following. Example number 4. Let f of z be analytic . Use Cauchy's theorem or Cauchy integral formula, right? Use Cauchy's integral formula to show that f at point W equals 1 over 2 pi integral from 0 to 2 pi f at W plus pi e to the I theta d theta. And we can do this both ways. We can start with Cauchy's integral formula and get it into this form, or we can start with this formula and get Cauchy's integral formula. So first, let's start with Cauchy's formula. So Cauchy's formula, here we have f at W. So we can write that f at W equals 1 over 2 pi I integral along some contour C f of z dz, and here z minus W. So here notations are slightly changed. So W acts as our z sub zero, and the rest is the same, right? So now how we can get to this form. So let's think of a contour C as some circle. So what circle we should choose? Right? So we want W to be cancelled, so let's take Z as a circle centered at point W. So basically what we need to get, this expression. So let's choose Z to be pi e to the I theta. And in this case, we will have dizzy to be pi I e to the I theta d theta. And let's see what we have. So we have 1 over 2 pi I integral would be along this circle z minus w equals pi, and f will become f at w plus pi e to the I theta, and then from here dz is times pi I e to the I theta d theta, and everything will be divided by z minus w, so that we will have here pi e to the I theta. And since we wrote the integration with respect to theta, so now we can change, we can say that theta is our parameter that runs from 0 to 2 pi, and here, since everything written in terms of theta, here we can also write that theta runs from 0 to 2 pi, and let's see what we have. So this I and this I, they are cancelled, and this pi and this pi are cancelled, and this is cancelled. So let's see if we got everything we wanted to. We just have 1 over 2 pi times the integral from 0 to 2 pi f of w plus pi e to the I theta d theta. And this is exactly what we wanted, so I can move this 1 over 2 pi here. So that's what we wanted to do. We can do similar thing if we just start from this expression. So then we will go backwards. We will say that this would be our variable z, and our contour would be z minus w with radius p, and then from here we can go all the way back in here. So this was our last example for today. Thank you.